2, Section 2, Biology, DNA. Here are the learning objectives. Make sure to spend some time during your study going over them. The structure of DNA. In the 1950s, Francis Crick and James Watson worked together at the University of Cambridge, England, to determine the structure of DNA. Now let's consider the structure of the nucleic acid, deoxyribonucleic acid, DNA. The building blocks of DNA are nucleotides, which are made up of three parts, a deoxyribose, 5-carbon sugar, a phosphate group, and a nitrogenous base. There are four types of nitrogenous bases in DNA. Adenine, A, and guanine, G, are double-ring purines, and cytosine, C, and thymine, T, are smaller, single-ring pyrimidines. The nucleotide is named according to the nitrogenous base it contains. Watson and Crick proposed that the DNA is made up of two strands that are twisted around each other to form a right-handed helix, called a double helix. Base pairing takes place between a purine and pyrimidine, namely, A pairs with T, and G pairs with C. In other words, adenine and thymine are complementary base pairs, and cytosine and guanine are also complementary base pairs. DNA is a working molecule. It must be replicated when a cell is ready to divide, and it must be read to produce the molecules, such as proteins, to carry out the functions of the cell. For this reason, the DNA is protected and packaged in very specific ways. Ultimately, DNA is compacted into a chromosome structure as shown in the figure above. The flow of genetic information in cells from DNA to mRNA to protein is described by the central dogma, which states that genes specify the sequences of mRNAs, which in turn specify the sequences of proteins. With the genes bound in the nucleus, transcription occurs in the nucleus of the cell, and the mRNA transcript must be transported to the cytoplasm. Transcription always proceeds from one of the two DNA strands, which is called the template strand. The mRNA product is complementary to the template strand, and is almost identical to the other DNA strand, called the non-template strand. In addition to the mRNA template, many other molecules contribute to the process of translation. The composition of each component may vary across species. For instance, ribosomes may consist of different numbers of ribosomal RNAs (RNA) and polypeptides depending on the organism. To summarize what we know to this point, the cellular process of transcription generates messenger RNA, mRNA, a mobile molecular copy of one or more genes with an alphabet of A, C, G, and uracil, U. Translation of the mRNA template converts nucleotide-based genetic information into a protein product. Protein sequences consist of 20 commonly occurring amino acids. Therefore, it can be said that the protein alphabet consists of 20 letters. Each amino acid is defined by a 3-nucleotide sequence called the triplet codon. The relationship between a nucleotide codon and its corresponding amino acid is called the genetic code. Here are the key terms. Codon, 3 consecutive nucleotides in mRNA that specify the addition of a specific amino acid or the release of a polypeptide chain during translation. Double helix, the molecular shape of DNA in which two strands of nucleotides wind around each other in a spiral shape. mRNA, messenger RNA, a form of RNA that carries the nucleotide sequence code for a protein sequence that is translated into a polypeptide sequence. Mutation, a permanent variation in the nucleotide sequence of a genome. Thank you. Next video, gene technologies.